Here it is another case, you know, with was not very conclusive, and this illustrates how complicated can be the diagnosis of HIT. And this is a patient with a HIT suspect secondary to metastatic adrenocarcinoma, and this HIT was suspect because there was a fall in platelet count. But the anticoagulation was already anticipated with warfarin, and HIT was suspected. But the test being negative, the patient received again heparin, and the platelet count normalized. Okay, and then there is again a fall, an abrupt fall in platelet count, which again makes the suspicion of HIT. In this case, and despite you know the reintroduction of heparin, there is again a normalization of platelet fall, heparin being used because there was a new pulmonary embolism. And you know that in true clinical context, this slide shows how complicated it can be. And you know it is not obvious which induces in this case this successive falls of platelet counts, which are not typical from a heparin-dependent antibody. But we had a similar case 10 years ago, which was reported as a letter to editor with a French group in the New England Journal of Medicine in patients with cancer. And this atypical platelet fall was produced by antibodies to IL-8. And you know, in this case, IL-8 antibodies are present at a high concentration because of the pathology. They are not harmful by themselves, and IL-8 antibodies can contribute to control the inflammatory response by lowering its effect. So they can be beneficial. But when the patient receives heparin, IL-8 has a high affinity for heparin, and then IL-8 is targeted onto endothelial cells or platelet surfaces, and then it can focus the immune response on these cells. And then they can produce a syndrome which is like a pseudo-HIT, with always these successive platelet fall, which are observed. But you know, in this case, we have not the information. I am speaking on the experience we had with Professor Leconte and Dr. Demestre in Nancy, in France, at this time, on a similar patient who had a similar pattern in platelet count evolution. So finally, I would like to present two atypical cases with protamine sulfate antibodies, and two other atypical cases with antibodies to PFR, probably pre-existing the occurrence of HIT. I already showed when I presented the diagnostic assays that we had two patients who were not inhibited by heparin and who were negative with streptavidine, heparin, biotinate heparin assay. And these patients were both from intensive care units in cardiology, and both had extracorporeal circulation, anticoagulate with heparin, and receive a bolus of protamine sulfate for neutralization of excess of heparin. Both developed severe thrombocytopenia 5 or 7 days after this event, and it was highly suggestive of HIT. So, the first case is summarized on this slide. It was a male, 40 years old, who had extracorporeal circulation and surgery for implantation of an artificial heart while waiting for a heart graft. And this patient was on anticoagulated with unfractionated heparin during cardiopulmonary bypass, and it was this treatment was rapidly switched to low molecular weight heparin the following day. And this patient developed renal insufficiency, and platelets were, you know, low but above 100 giga per liter until day 6, so rather stable. And at the beginning of day 7, they dropped suddenly to 30 gigapper liter with a rapid fatal evolution due to a massive thrombosis of the digestive system. And heart electrodes were infected, and this patient had also an antibiotic therapy, but it was suspected because of this rapid fall on day 7. The other case, the first case was from Professor Ludovic Drouet in Paris, and the second case is from Professor Simon Panzer in Vienna. And this case was also a male, 50 years old, with a history of circulatory and coronary disease. And he was admitted for ischemic cardiopathy, cardiomyopathy, aortic valve stenosis, and mitral valve insufficiency. He had in the past surgery for mitral valve replacement and aortic valve reconstruction under extracorporeal circulation. So no, he had this, but he had already a surgery 10 years before. And in this case, he had the surgery on day one. And anticoagulation was continued with unfractionated heparin. And platelet counts remained at just below 100 giga per liter, with a tendency to increase from day one to day two, but still remaining low. And they reach 80 giga per liter on these segments. And this patient had, again, a new surgery for total artificial heart replacement, so very similar to the former case. He again had extracorporeal circulation and heparin neutralization with protamine sulfase. And anticoagulation was continued with unfractionated heparin for another day. And platelets fall again rapidly at 31 giga per liter. And heparin was immediately replaced with argatroban when heat was suspected. And these two cases, you know, negative or weakly positive with the streptavidin heparin assay, positive with the protamine sulfate heparin assay, and not inhibited by an excess of heparin. Okay? And we show later that these patients were highly reactive with protamine sulfate alone, or one of them still more reactive with protamine sulfate complex with heparin. And you know, the control plate coat with BSA, with bovine serum albumin, is totally negative, which shows the specificity for protamine sulfate. And interestingly, you know, when you look at literature, there are many reports showing some allergenic events in patients treated receiving protamine sulfate. And even if association of these antibodies with HIT are not yet reported, we have more and more evidence on their implication in some pseudo-HIT cases. So the other case is also very surprising. It is very unusual, but it is characteristic. So this case was also a patient for Professor Simon Panzer in Vienna, and it concerned a young female, 28 years old, which was admitted for hemiplegia, and was treated with heparin, unfractionated heparin, for 2 days. And this induced a drop of platelet count, so from 150 giga to 50 giga. As her clinical context, you know, was worsening, she had decompressive hemicraniectomy, and there was withdrawal of heparin, and this induced development of pulmonary embolism, but not too severe. And there was a suspicion of HIT. There was a variable platelet count, you know, which remained just below or just above 100 giga per liter, despite heparin was discontinued.